Looking back throughout Formula One history, there have been some truly incredible rookie seasons. From Ayrton Senna in 1984 to Michael Schumacher's debut in 91 and then his first full season in 92, as well as the first full season for Sebastian Vettel in 2008 as well. All of their debut seasons showed the talent that they had at a very early age and set the blueprint for their careers that these legendary drivers would go on to have, which by the way would combine to give 14 drivers' titles. But today, I'm going to be talking about Lewis Hamilton's debut in 2007. Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Aldas, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about the greatest rookie season in Formula One history. Now, I had a great time putting this video together, doing all the research, watching the 2007 season because it was absolutely amazing. And I do hope that you guys enjoy this video as much as I enjoyed making it. Now, also don't forget that if you do enjoy my content, then don't forget to drop a like, smash that subscribe button, and check out my social medias. Instagram and Twitter will be above. But guys, let's get into it. Now, before we fully delve into Lewis Hamilton's rookie season, let's take a look at how Lewis got into Formula One and why he was also quite possibly the most hyped rookie F1 had ever seen. Now, Lewis Hamilton was born on the 7th of January in 1985 and grew up in a small town in England called Stevenage. Like many, his journey to Formula One began with karting, and it was quickly apparent that Lewis Hamilton had talent on the track. He began tearing up the track as a junior and won multiple karting championships, and it wasn't long until he was starting to grab the attention of not only the public but also the British media, not just because of his immense talent but also because he was the only black driver on the karting scene growing up, and this drew a lot of interest in the media. Everything would change, however, when at the age of 10, Lewis met Ron Dennis, the head of McLaren and the guy that had been running McLaren throughout their most successful period and had managed drivers like Ayrton Senna and Alain Prost in their prime when they were teammates. He told Ron that one day he wanted to get to Formula One and race in one of his cars, after which Ron Dennis famously wrote in Lewis's autograph book, "Phone me in 9 years and we'll sort something out then." It wouldn't take that long for Ron Dennis to come back to him, as a few years later, at the age of 13, McLaren officially signed Lewis Hamilton to their young driver program, also eventually making him the youngest person ever to be signed to a young driver program who would eventually go on and get a seat in Formula One. Hamilton would next move into single-seater racing, and once again his talent was obvious as he would go on to win multiple championships as he climbed the ladder to Formula One. Whilst McLaren knew about Lewis since his early years, it's when he was at GP2 that he really began to grab the attention of everyone in the paddock as the next big thing. And in his maiden year at GP2, he showed his speed and maturity once again with some amazing drives, like his incredible comeback after an early spin in Turkey. It was an absolutely just unbelievable display of both late braking and his racing ability. And if you've never seen the highlights of that race, then definitely go check them out, as I'll have them linked below. It was honestly just, as a racing fan, it's absolutely incredible to watch. And it wasn't like Lewis Hamilton was beating random mugs off the street. He was up against a stacked field of future racing champions, which included the likes of Nelson Piquet Jr., Jose Maria Lopez, and Lucas Degrassi, to name a few. It was now almost an inevitability that Lewis Hamilton would get that McLaren seat. He had driven and tested for McLaren on multiple occasions and had achieved absolutely everything he could possibly achieve in the lower categories. Finally, the stars aligned, with Kimi Raikkonen departing the team to replace the retiring Michael Schumacher at Ferrari. A space opened up and Ron Dennis took the leap of faith and announced on the 24th of November in 2006 that it would be Lewis Hamilton to partner their other new driver, the two-time defending world champion Fernando Alonso, for the 2007 Formula One season. After the announcement, Lewis was understandably ecstatic and said, "It's a dream come true. To be racing in Formula One with McLaren has been the ultimate goal for me since I was very young, and this opportunity is a fantastic way to end what has been the best year for me. I have grown up with McLaren and Mercedes and wouldn't be where I am today without their continued support and guidance. However, I am aware that this will be a challenge, and I know that there will be a lot of attention on me." And saying that there would be a lot of attention on him would be a massive understatement. His speed and talent are what got him into Formula One, but the fans and the media and the pressure surrounding him at the time were mainly due to the color of his skin. It's something that him and his dad, Anthony Hamilton, had been dealing with ever since they started karting. In his own words, his dad was his biggest inspiration and had to work three jobs to get Lewis through karting. And now that they finally got to Formula One, the pressure and the expectations were higher than ever. And as much as some people try to almost ignore it, the race aspect was an important one, especially for Formula One because of what it represented. There have been 774 Formula One drivers since the sport's inception in 1950, and of those 774, even to this day in 2020, there has only ever been one black Grand Prix driver, and that is Lewis Hamilton. The hype and pressure that the media were putting on Lewis Hamilton was almost unimaginable, with one journalist even saying that he is already being hailed as motorsport's answer to Tiger Woods. Oh, and by the way, just in case I didn't clarify this earlier, to add even more pressure onto him, if that's even possible, let's just remind ourselves one more time who he was going up against in his rookie season. Fernando Alonso, the defending two-time world champion that had just dethroned, statistically, the greatest driver of all time in Michael Schumacher. For Fernando, this was a dream. He had made it into McLaren, now as the defending double world champion in a car that was actually looking from testing like it was going to be a title contender. And to have a rookie as your teammate, I mean, it was almost too easy. There was even reports in 2007 that were saying that Fernando questioned McLaren's decision to have a rookie driver if they had title aspirations. So in Alonso's mind, he already had half a hand on the title before the season even started. So, finally came the highly anticipated 2007 season and the even more highly anticipated debut of Lewis Hamilton at the 2007 Australian Grand Prix. Immediately, Lewis looked comfortable in the McLaren and qualified fourth, just 0.2 ahead of Alonso. Then on the Sunday, Lewis Hamilton improved on his qualifying and finished his first ever race on the podium in third place, making it the best race debut since 1996. But one of the most memorable and most defining moments of that season came at the very first corner on the very first lap. Now, Lewis Hamilton off the line actually didn't get the best of start and dropped down to fifth, but then on the very first corner of his career, he took the advantage of the battling going on out front and drove clean around the outside of both Kubica and teammate Alonso to go from fifth into third. Now, this was a big sign of just how confident Lewis was from the get-go, and although Fernando overtook Lewis later on in the race to claim second place, it was a big wake-up call that this rookie was no joke. The next two races in Malaysia and Bahrain would be another jump up for Hamilton as he would take back-to-back second place finishes. But it wasn't just the results that were impressing everyone about the rookie, it was his racing ability that he carried over from GP2 as he continued to pull some great moves like overtaking both Raikkonen and Massa in two corners on the opening lap in Malaysia. Next came the Spanish Grand Prix, and yet again another great performance from Hamilton as he took another second place finish, making it 4 out of 4 podiums in his first 4 races. That's just incredible. But the astonishing thing was that after all this consistency, and despite not actually having a win yet, Lewis Hamilton would now leave Barcelona leading the Drivers' Championship for the first time in his career after only 4 races, something that was truly unprecedented for a rookie. However, next would be Monaco, and arguably the beginning of the end for Lewis and Fernando's relationship. Now, the 2007 Monaco Grand Prix was a strange race because from the outside, it was a perfect weekend for McLaren, a 1-2 with Fernando Alonso showing his class around the streets of Monte Carlo and taking the W over his teammate Lewis Hamilton, but more importantly, over a 1 minute gap back to their rivals Ferrari, so a perfect weekend for McLaren. Well, not really. There was immediately a little bit of controversy over their differing strategies, with Alonso on a one-stop and Hamilton on the slower two-stop. Alonso was cruising to victory. He always really seemed to have a bit of a pace advantage over Lewis Hamilton, but Lewis kept pushing. In the end, Lewis was left frustrated, and on top of that, there was also some team orders later on by Ron Dennis for them not to race and just to bring the cars home. Now, added to that, according to Pedro de la Rosa, who was the team test driver in 2007, 7, he later said on the Beyond the Grid podcast that Ron Dennis actually later told Fernando Alonso that the race should have been won by Lewis because he was quicker, which did not please Fernando, to say the least. Now, that was a great interview, and I'll have it on screen, and definitely kind of also have like the time when he talked about the 2007 Monaco incident. But yeah, guys, definitely also go give a watch to that Beyond the Grid podcast, because yeah, Pedro de la Rosa has some amazing stories and certainly some really good insight into the 2007 season in McLaren. So again, on the outside, a perfect weekend with the perfect team result, but already it was obvious that a rift between them was beginning to form. Next up, we go to Canada and a landmark moment for Lewis Hamilton. Up to this point, Lewis had finished every single race on the podium and was on a 4-race streak of second place finishes. But finally, this was Lewis Hamilton's big moment as he took his first ever pole position, almost 5/10 ahead of second place Fernando Alonso, and then converted that pole in a very chaotic race, actually, with a flawless performance to bring his first ever Formula One win. Understandably, it was a very emotional moment for Lewis, and he dedicated his first win to his dad, as this was a massive dream for them growing up to win a Formula One Grand Prix. The success for Lewis Hamilton would continue at the US Grand Prix with back-to-back poles and wins after a thrilling showdown against Fernando Alonso, but once again there was a frustration on the side of Fernando Alonso, as on one of the laps during the race he drove alongside the pit wall, seemingly trying to send a message to Ron Dennis and the pit wall of his frustrations. Now, whether it was something inside the team or whether it was that he was being beaten by a rookie, Fernando was not happy, and now the driver troubles were for all the world to see. The next few races at Magny Cours and Silverstone would see a Ferrari resurgence as Kimi Raikkonen would take back-to-back wins. However, the ever-consistent Hamilton yet again was on the podium for both with back-to-back third-place finishes. This now meant that in 9 races, Lewis took 9 consecutive podiums with 2 race wins, and at this point he had now taken a 12-point lead in the championship, which back in those days, because of the point system, was a serious advantage. Next up would be the German Grand Prix, and truly one of the best and most chaotic and craziest races in the history of Formula One. Somehow, if you've never seen it, go and try and find somewhere to watch the 2007 German Grand Prix. It was a race of high attrition with lots of people crashing everywhere in a very wet Nürburgring track, and would also be the first race of the season where Lewis Hamilton would finish off the podium in 7th place. Now, over halfway into the season, the main talking points was the strained relationship inside McLaren between Fernando Alonso and Lewis Hamilton. Fernando even came out and said to a Spanish journalist that McLaren were favouring Hamilton because he was a British driver and that he wasn't being fully accepted into the team. Now, there's no doubt in my mind that part of this was true, but both drivers and Ron Dennis did try to keep everything quiet. However, it was clear and obvious for everyone to see. Now, it was around this time that there was also reports of racially insensitive comments aimed at Lewis Hamilton coming from certain Spanish journalists. Now, it's something that sadly followed Hamilton throughout much of his early career and obviously follows him to this day. As much as it has improved, it was really bad in those early days, even escalating to a disgusting moment at the start of the 2008 season during pre-season testing, where some people turned up to Barcelona pre-season testing and came and watched the cars in black face with t-shirts reading Hamilton family. Now, that was absolutely just disgusting, and F1 actually threatened to cancel that year's Spanish Grand Prix if Spain did not do anything about it, but it once again just outlined the horrendous challenges Hamilton was also facing off the track and the horrible abuse he was subjected to as well. So going into the second half of the season, the next 4 races would easily be some of the hardest for McLaren, with massive controversy both on and off the track. Now, Hungary 2007 was a very famous moment and one that we all know pretty well, but of course, for those of you that don't know, it was basically the moment that saw Hamilton and Alonso and their divide kind of reach its absolute peak. In qualifying, Hamilton was told to let Alonso pass on a track. Now, Hamilton ignored team orders because, by his own admission, he did not get a good enough reason to do so. Now, this infuriated Alonso so much that at the next round of pit stops, less than 2 minutes before the end of Q3, run. Ron Dennis was absolutely furious. He was just absolutely livid by this and was summoned to the stewards. Alonso was given a five-place grid penalty for unnecessarily impeding another driver, promoting Hamilton to pole, and McLaren would score no constructors' points for that race. On the Sunday, Hamilton converted the pole and led every single lap on the way to victory, but that was not the big talking point. Now, at this point, there was a huge amount of British bias, in my opinion, in the media, laying all the blame on Alonso for blocking their new sporting hero. But the truth is, Hamilton was just as much to blame for ignoring team orders earlier in quali. And as for Fernando, McLaren at this point had basically turned their backs on him. Now, again, kind of contradicting myself, literally everything I just said in the past 20 seconds, I do kind of also see the point from Lewis Hamilton, because at the time he was fighting for a championship, and when you have that champion's mentality, you honestly sometimes have to be selfish. So I do kind of get it from his point of view, but in his rookie season, and this is something even Ron Dennis kind of elaborated later on in his career, he thought that Lewis Hamilton was actually at fault for the 2007 incident for not following team orders in the first place. But in reality, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter who's right and who's wrong, they were both at fault for the incident at Hungary in 2007. So, F1 headed into the final third of the season, and after 12 races, the championship was still a four-horse race between Hamilton, Alonso, Massa, and Raikkonen, with each of them amazingly taking three race victories each up until this point. However, between both the Italian and the Belgium Grand Prix, McLaren would be involved yet again in another controversy as they were found guilty of what would later be called the Spygate scandal. Now, I'm not going to go into it in this video, there is a lot surrounding the Spygate scandal, but in terms of what it meant for the drivers, they were granted immunity for what happened, whilst the team were given a $100 million fine and McLaren were disqualified from the Constructors' Championship for 2007. So getting away from all the controversy and back on the track, next up, F1 headed to Fuji for another thrilling wet race. This time, Lewis Hamilton reigned supreme, demonstrating his incredible wet weather driving capabilities and took a flawless win from pole position. It was almost a relief for McLaren to finally make headlines, but for the right reasons. As for Lewis Hamilton, heading into the final two races, he now extended his lead in the Drivers' Championship and could now clinch the driver's title in his maiden season next time out in China. Now, this is where things get a little rocky. The Chinese Grand Prix looked for all the world to be the place where, for the first time in Formula One history, a rookie would claim the title, and Lewis Hamilton got also the best start by claiming pole position. However, it all began to unravel for him from there. As the race got underway, Lewis Hamilton maintained the lead before a sudden change in the weather from wet to dry. Both him and Raikkonen were fighting heavily for the lead in a really good battle yet again until the track dried out and both of them needed to change tyres. Despite Lewis losing the lead on track to Kimi, he was still in the right place to win the world title in terms of the points when out of nowhere, as he came into the pits to change his badly worn tyres, he locked up and slid at the pit entry and got his car beached in the gravel. Now, it was honestly unbelievable to see that happen and a massive shock. It was a mistake and almost seemed like for the first time the pressure had really gotten to Lewis Hamilton. Oh, and by the way, guys, in case you wanted to know, Shanghai would ironically later remove that gravel trap just before the pit entry, but not before a certain Pastor Maldonado would give it one last go. So now, heading into the final race at Brazil, it was now a three-way fight between Hamilton, Alonso, and Raikkonen for the championship. It would be a great title showdown with each of the drivers at various points in the race mathematically being title leaders. In the end, it was Kimi out of nowhere, having only led the title at the very first race of the season in Australia, who would win the 2007 World Championship as he claimed victory in Brazil. As for Lewis, in the race, he was on course to finish in a position that would give him the title, but after having a gearbox issue mid-race, which cost him over 40 seconds of race time and sent him to almost the back of the grid, it was a horrible bit of bad luck that snatched the dream of a maiden title out of his reach, as he couldn't quite make up the positions throughout the race that he needed. In the end, 2 points separated the top three in one of the closest championship deciders in Formula One history. And although both Hamilton and Alonso finished with the same amount of points on countback, because Lewis achieved more second place finishes, he legitimately finished ahead of Alonso in the championship and beat a two-time world champion in his rookie season. So yeah, the dream of winning a title in his rookie season slipped from his fingers, but it was a massive learning curve for Lewis Hamilton, and it was still an amazing year for him, full of many highs and yes, some lows along the way as well. And we've seen great rookie seasons and great rookie performances since then from the likes of Verstappen and Leclerc, but neither of them compared to Hamilton's. When you look back and really appreciate what Lewis was up against, the pressure from the media who was scrutinizing him at every turn, the British fan base looking for their next British champion, from all of the controversies throughout the year, the constant power struggle between him and Alonso, and on top of all of that, to go up against three experienced drivers in their absolute prime as a rookie. I mean, what he achieved and the impact he made on F1 was simply phenomenal. And still, to this day, he produced the greatest rookie season the sport had ever seen. Oh, and by the way, to answer the question, would Hamilton turn out to be a one-season wonder? Well, not exactly. He turned out to be a pretty alright driver, to say the least. Well guys, there you go. That is my video on the greatest rookie season in F1 history. Let me know in the comments below guys what you thought of the 2007 season. Have you seen it? Have you not? If you haven't, then I highly go and recommend you watch maybe some of the races or the highlights, because we do have a little bit of a gap until our next Formula One race, and I highly recommend it. It is an absolute classic. And also let me know, do you agree or disagree with me in terms of Lewis Hamilton having the best rookie season in F1 history? If you don't, then let me know in the comments below who you think has had the greatest rookie season. Anyway, as I said, I hope you did enjoy this video, and if you did, don't forget to drop a like, smash that subscribe button, and check out my social medias. Instagram and Twitter will be above. And also don't forget guys to stay safe and stay indoors, but I do hope you guys are keeping well. Anyway, I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys.